So let's meet Roberta, an entrepreneur who once struggled with delegation. When she came to me, she was clearly so overworked that she no longer had time to attend to her appearance. She had so many strong beliefs against the hiring of employees, and the thought of delegating her tasks to them was definitely a no-no. It took us quite some time to dig into her childhood to find out what is it really making her refuse to hire and to trust anyone. In many cases like this, all one has to be aware of is that it is a strong belief that's blocking her way. And once the awareness comes, the rest would be easy. So as I led her through some close-eyed process, she was able to identify how those beliefs all started. She also knew how those beliefs have kept her playing small since then. And they have also kept her stuck in the many times when she had turned down all the opportunities she could have had to move forward in her life as well as her business. So after just a few sessions with her, she became open to adopting effective delegation practices. And slowly, she saw her business began to flourish. Her journey highlights that delegation is not just about lightening your load. It's about nurturing your team and consequently growing your business. It also showed us that sometimes, even when we do not know how, or even when we know how and what to do, something way back in our history, in our life history, could keep us stuck. And talking things over with a qualified coach can help one process the painful experiences and then move forward with more courage and certainty. Roberta's experience shows us that effective delegation is a catalyst for business growth and also for one's personal well-being.